Hello, our friends, Evolutionary Energy Arts families. So, guys, we're keeping to shorter, smaller topic news items for the express reason of finding out what triggers algorithms to get defensive. So there's a couple of things we're going to be really talking about very shortly. One of them, as we want to thank our Patreons, as always, for their support. And recently we've had quite a few people joining the Patreon family. Again, exclusives going up there on a regular basis each week. And Cindy is looking to get some more information in from the Galactic Federation. And, you know, these times, as you know, are so critical. One of the items that's really hot right now is talking about Russia firing an ICBM. This is an intercontinental ballistic missile into Ukraine for the first time, and Kiev confirms this. Okay, so this is the first time that an ICBM has been used. What's the big deal? Well, this missile that they used could reach anywhere in Europe. It could reach anywhere. It could reach London, Paris. It could reach Rome. It could reach, again, anywhere in Europe. This is an ICBM. So, you know, again, this is what typically would carry in the case of a NUKE war. This is these are the big ones. These are the big ones. The range is 3,700 miles. So, you know, why would they do this and then basically shoot it not too far over the border? As, you know, the target was in Ukraine. The target was not Kiev. Now, it's interesting because there was a lot of rumors that they were going to target Kiev, which is the capital of Ukraine. And if you look at a map from 980 AD and you look at the Russian-Ukraine area, what you see is one kingdom called Kievan Rus. And again, at one point in time, that was one people, a conglomerate of tribes of Slavic background and also of what we would call Nordic background. The European and the world map changes constantly. These countries, you know, they ebb and flow, they rise and fall, and yet here is humanity on the edge of perhaps the biggest war in our known time, and it's all about borders. You know, again, there's a bigger purpose here. So a senior Ukrainian military official told the Financial Times that Russia launched an ICBM called the RS-26 Rubes that has a range of 3,700 miles and can strike anywhere in Europe. You know, again, it's the use of this that we've not seen before, as you see footage that shows the Russian ICBM and its multiple re-entry vehicles. Now, this missile carries multiple warheads. So, again, it's not one missile, one warhead. What happens is the missile goes up, the missile comes down, and then it releases multiple warheads that would each have an impact. And if this was armed with something nuclear, what you would see is not one big mushroom cloud, but many mushroom clouds all coming together. This is the first time in history they say that this was used. This is obviously a message because, you know, you don't see any big warheads coming up. No, this is just saying this is what can be done. And by the way, it hit a defense plant. This is what can be done. And this is definitely them saying we withheld a big strike just to show you. Now, it's interesting. This missile was launched from Astrakhan. Astrakhan. That's an interesting word, to say the least. And I definitely want to go into a little bit more detail there. Ukrainian Patriot missile systems can intercept short-range missiles, but they can't. They're not optimized, as this article says, to take out an ICBM. this is something different. This is a totally different level to things. So the missile targeted industrial and critical infrastructure, causing fires and injuring two people. Obviously, this could have been so much worse, so much worse. Back to that word, it was shot from Astrakhan. In my understanding, Khan can mean things like village or town. Astra, now that's the part that I wanted to go into. And Astra in Sanskrit is a supernatural weapon in the Hindu epics. It's presided over by a specific deity and imbued with spiritual and occult powers. The term came to denote any weapon that was released from the hand, like an arrow, as opposed to something like a sword. So Astra can, you know, again, what is an arrow? It's a projectile, it's a missile. So when we look to the old times and we hear these stories about these ancient battles in which they loosed arrows upon each other, in reality, because we have kind of blown ourselves back to the Stone Age, so to speak, perhaps time and time and time again, maybe those arrows were really more like missiles. And here you go, introducing the Astraverse. This is again coming from Bollywood. Bollywood is like India's Hollywood, is what it's come to be known as. And if you've ever seen any of the remakes of the Greco-Roman and even Egyptian myths and legends that Hollywood has put out, well, there's a ton of them portraying the Hindu myths that Bollywood has. The Astraverse. Astraverse. There's that word again. Brahmastra, we've talked about. Now, Brahma, again, one of the trinity of Hindu gods there. The Brahmastra is a gift from Brahma, so to speak. And this one is a series of movies coming out. This one, part one, Shiva. And by the way, there's a statue of Shiva at CERN, because Shiva is, again, the destroyer of the illusion. Interesting, and also about basically rewriting different timelines. You can say that Shiva is also definitely about creating new timelines. Brahmastra was a weapon that was used in the times of the Mahabharata to, according to literal translations, wipe out 1.3, 1.4 billion, billion people. Again, you can see how this is a big thing over in Bollywood. And again, in the West, we have our Greco-Roman mythologies. We've seen, the Egyptian and the Greek gods resurrected in different series. I know Netflix did one with Jeff Goldblum as Zeus, and that's a curious choice of acting for Zeus. But here you see the most powerful weapons of the Mahabharata. Make note of the shapes. Make note of how they look. And look at this one in particular right here, as you have your Astras. And the ancient weapons of India, you can see there's many different weapons. And it's fascinating to go into Vimanas. There's many different types of Vimanas. And Vimanas, in effect, certainly when you start looking at the different Vimanas out there, there's some that look very, very much like cities in the sky, and others that look more like typical UFOs that we would see nowadays. Of course, the battle of the Devas against the Devas, by the way, again, in so many ways you could see how the system has taken something D-E-V-A-S, and they've taken Devas and turned it into devils. Now, these are actually the good guys. And yet in the West, it's been shifted. The Asuras are the bad guys. You know, the Asuras are the ones that are in total service to self and that take over lands and instill themselves as the rulers and demand worship, demand the first of everything. This is in a lot of ways, this is where your tithing comes from, and you're giving to the church, etc. So Astra is a projectile missile-like weapon. And you can invoke these things by hymns, too. You can get boons where you actually acquire these type of things. Shastra is a handheld weapon, like a sword, a lance, or a mace. And so why are we talking about all this? Well, it's fascinating because this is Elon's bedside table. What do you see? You see Washington crossing the Delaware, Valley Forge whole thing. You see an old school, looks like a duelist, musket firing gun, lots of Diet Coke. I just don't think he really would, but maybe he does take in the Nanu Nanu with the Diet Coke. A massive gun. I don't know if that's like a Taurus Judge or something. And, wait a minute, what's that? Yeah, that's what we've been talking about. Why? And a lot of people, when I first saw this picture, a lot of people were commenting, why does he have one of these Hindu legendary weapons at bedside? Why? A replica gun of the old times, you know, something that's massive. You know, some of these actually literally shoot shotgun shells. And a magical weapon. Hey, Elon, what's up with this? And then, by the way, over here, you see Jay Anderson. So Donald Trump has an Ark of the Covenant replica in his home in Mar-a-Lago. Isn't that curious? Elon Musk has an ancient Vedic weapon, the Vajra, on his bedside table. Why? Because nothing has ever changed and they telegraph it. It's a continuation of the wars from those ancient times. This guy knows, you know, nothing is going to replace us and our relationships with each other and working together. And that is really what you see in the Vedic world. It is a divine battle going on, and there, it's also a very real battle. Again, in the Vedas, not just the Vedas, but the Mahabharata and the Puranas and the Upanishads, it's clearly known and it's explained in open detail. There's no hiding this, that there are extraterrestrial wars, there are interdimensional wars, there are beings that live inside the Earth. So it's well known that there's beings from out there living in different star systems, living inside the Earth itself with much more technology than we have. And that these battles sometimes do include us. And, you know, this is the big revelation. It's not hidden there. It's just open there. In fact, they talk of over 100,000 types of humanoid beings that live in our galaxy alone. The one thing you could count on is your pup. You know, if people were more like dogs, this would be a much, much better world. Because, again, they show their love. They show their loyalty. They look out for each other. They work as a pack. We have been turned on and against each other instead of working to protect, you know, each other and to protect the pack. They divide us down into smaller groups, and they set us upon each other. These wars of the gods have never stopped, and the only difference is now that we're not going to be in the Kali Yuga anymore. It's going to become well known, but they will still recruit you to the individual sides. As always, guys, thanks for your support. Much love, source bless, and namaste.